to the colour circle studio where I'm teaching a pastel class this morning, and I just thought before I start the pastel class I might do a quick demo for you. And today in the class I'm going to be talking about using earth colours. When we're painting landscapes, it's very tempting to go for those lovely jewel-like colours that we love in pastel box, the high chroma colours, to describe bright green fields and yellow flowers and so on, and a big blue sky. But sometimes that can just undermine our intention of showing a nice natural landscape. And if we use earth colours to block in and to start the painting, and then just keep those high chroma colours for the icing on the cake at the end, some flowers in the field, touches of sunlight, that kind of thing, then we'll get a much more natural landscape, a natural painting, and that's what we're after often. Today what I'm using for the paper is some Art Spectrum Colour Fix paper. It's from their original rainbow pack, and it has, that pack actually has all their colours in there. They're great colours, and it's a nice textured paper. So it's like the My Tense Tex, a very gritty UART paper. So it's a great paper, one of my favourites to work on. So I've chosen an earth colour. Here's the materials I'm going to be using for this demonstration. Down here I have a set of Richard McKinley Landscape. You can just see there, that's the set, the Terry Ludwig pastels, Richard McKinley chosen set of landscapes pastels, and that's them there. Then I have some extra soft square pastels by Art Spectrum, and they're Australian Earths, and great set of colours. And a little tiny box next here, just some handmade pastels out of bits of pastel dust left over from paintings that I collect and make into neutral pastels. They're quite good sometimes. And this will be the reference photo today. It's a desert landscape from Arches National Park. First thing I'm going to do is just sketch up. I'm using an orange contour because it's nice and hard, and because it will help get the shapes in, and it will blend in with those colours. I'm bringing over here the kind of shapes of those mounds of desert sand there. And then up here, I've got that needs to go across. Up here, I've got the rocks. Those shapes in. Now this is one I'm going to have to, I'm often going to, don't worry too much about getting the exact shapes, but since this is a well-known arch in Arches National Park, I think I better get it fairly right. So I'm looking at the shapes next to each other and just doing it from there. To get those shapes right. It's a lovely, thin, delicate arch there. So we need to portray that in the painting. Sometimes you need to peer a little bit closer there to see what's actually happening, because the rock is in layers and there's a layer of rock behind it. And a couple of layers of rock behind it, in fact. This will just get me all set up for those shapes there. Sky up there, there's a little sort of hat on this top there. And then there's more. Just having a little
peer closer there. Carefully drawing at this stage to try and get the essence of this rock. And another smaller rock down here. Basic shapes now of the basic elements, the rocks, the arch, and the mounds of sand down there. So now I can start putting in the colour. I'm going to start with the sky just because I want to get that done so it's not going to fall down onto here. I'm not at home with my normal easel. So I'm just taking out from the Richard McKinley some blue, various blues here, and I'm going to be putting in some of that, just scrambling it across the surface with a couple of different blues. It's going to be fun, but I'm saying the sun's in that corner of the sky, therefore this corner will be a little bit darker, further away from the sun, the bluer and darker the sky is. So there comes that. And it's got the other gradient as it comes down the sky, it's lighter. So I'll have three gradients, the two gradients there going, light to dark, dark to light. I'm not worried about covering up all of that sky, because some of that sure might be a problem for me. Lighten it off down here, and then I'm going to get a little smudge in, because I do want to cut the side of it, so just with the side of my finger, moving the pastel around to the surface of that paper, and you can see it dulls it down immediately when I do that, and I'll put in some more colour over the top, so I'm not too worried about that. Now I'll just go back in and add a little bit more. Over the top, just to give back that sparkle there. Then we're just wisping it over the top there, and then giving it a little flick with my finger to make it even more wispy. A little bit dense around the top of the rocks there. I'm making the pink to sort of reflect some of the colour of that warm colour off the rocks there. And I'll be adding in other light colours as we go. And over here where it's closer to the sun, I'll put some more of the yellow. So I don't want the clouds to just be white or grey. I want them to have some other colours in them. I'm going to bring a very pale blue as well with those clouds. And that's just to help, as I put it on the edges, to help to blend them in the rest of the sky. And at the edges it needs to soften up. So now I'm just going to wisp some of those edges, knock back the clouds slightly. I do want the clouds to cover that underneath paper, so here I'm just pushing down with my finger again, and that's blending all those light colours up here. And then round the edges, just a really nice whoosh with my fingers. To soften up where the clouds come into the sky.
So I've got a nice wispy kind of sky there, and now I'm going to just work back into it with some little touches of
more wispiness there. A little bit of yellow, a colour there on the edges, more sunlit edges, and a bluey sort of colour as well.
See, just by pulling it, flicking it across the surface, I'm getting those very wispy edges there. So that's the sky done, didn't take us long at all, and then I'm going to move on to the rocks. The rocks are, if we squint, very dark down here, lighter on the tops, lighter over this side, lighter on the top of the ridge. So what I want to do is get the shadows underneath there, which will help describe the arch, and then lighter top on top. I'm just starting with the lighter top. And this is too light for it, but I just want to start with it to get in those shapes. And I'm putting the light top, and then I'm going to add to that light top. But right now, that's just... And I'm using the edge of these square art spectrum ones. So that's given me nice crisp edge to the arch. Just pulling it down. I want to get that roundness back into it again. And you can see where I've just pulled it over that part. It lets some of this brown sparkle through. Now I'm taking a more orangey brown and adding that in. And around the edge there. Here I'm just taking it in and pulling it down and helping those two colours to blend. Again, just with that edge. That started my rocks, and I can see there that I need to put a little bit more of the sky in, which is what I'm going to do right now, so that I can keep working. Just put the sky in that little spot. I can go back in and just crisp up those edges again with my ponte if I need to. And at the end, that's what I'll be doing, crisping up everything. The top here is going to be thicker, quite thicker there. Nice and rounded, coming up. As I go, I'm just rechecking all my shapes, so that needs to be longer, and that needs to be round there, and down to that rock. I'm getting those first blocks of colour in. And then down here, I'm going to give that a slightly darker edge there. Just so I'm establishing everything from the start, I'm then going to go in with quite a dark colour and describe the underneath of this arch.
taken that. Maybe I have. And it comes right around down here, and it's all shadow there. Very, very thin there. So just blocking that in. General shape of my arch now, and that describe that big shadow. I'm going to go over and establish some of these other shadows here. So I've got some very dark browns, reddy sort of ochre, red earthy browns, and they're going in to describe that shape there, which is a shadow, and some more shadow on this rock down here. And there's quite a big shadowy bit on here. It's not as dark as the other, but I'm putting it in to start with this quite dark. And moving the pastel around so I get some sort of rock edges there. Across the back here, there's also some sort of shadows underneath those little rocks there. So I'm putting that in now. I'm just making some little marks with the flatter edge, the smaller flat edge, for the shadows on those rocks, underneath the rocks at the top there. There's a little shadow under that one there too. And this one has a bit of shadow as it comes around, down like so. And it would have, I don't know what, rounded top there. So then comes the top of it, round and down, and put some of that colour in. And then there's a lot more orangey yellows in it, so a bit of that colour, and then we'll work in some of this colour. And I'm letting it overlap here, so that I can moderate some of that. And I will be adding in some sort of bluey colours eventually here too, but right now I'm just getting in the reds and oranges. But there are quite a few other colours in those rocks. Over here it's more a bit lighter, but what I want to do now is take some of that colour and add it down here into the red desert sand. So I'm sweeping, basically sweeping around some nice big swathes of desert sand there. Back into this area as well. And then, not going to do too much to this desert sand here, because there's a whole lot of sage that's going to help describe that. And I want the front of it, the foreground, to be quite simple. So I'm just laying some of that on. Making a few little variations in it. I'm not going to do too much more of that foreground. In here, where the shadow is, it comes around back into the reddy sort of colour of the rocks. Over here, it's all a bit lighter, so I'm actually going to go in and use this colour to start with to bring in some of those rock shapes. On the top of that one. Dabs that come on top of those rocks. And start to build up a little bit of texture on these by making some marks as I go with the sides of that. Under here is another arch, almost arch. And as it comes down the side, it gets a little bit darker.
I'm going to take some of these purpley homemade ones, these very neutral ones and stuff, adding some of those in. So sort of nice neutral purples. And they're going to help to describe the sides of the rocks and the underhangs of the rocks here. It starts curving back around into this area. This one's a little bit more purple gold. And some purples in there. The front face of this has got some shadows on it as well. Deep into hollow in there. That is not round enough. So I'm just taking it back. So that's better. I'm never going to get this finished before my class arrive. That's okay. Sometimes you take a bit more than you can chew. This is a big swathe of shadow underneath here too, so putting that in. And it comes in sort of layers down there, with little bits of ledges and so on caught with the more bright spots, which we're just going to get the edge of the pastel. So just putting a few bright spots down there.